Hello guys, hope you are doing well. So today I am going to start a new series on Protractor. So in this series, you will learn what is JavaScript, what is TypeScript, then probably we'll move to the Protractor API, where I'm going to cover from the very basics to the advanced level. And then we will move to Cucumber, where we will learn what is VB and how to integrate Cucumber with Protractor API. And then also we will see what are the reports available for Protractor and how can we generate that. And first thing first, before starting the entire series, we have to do the installation and the project setup. So today's agenda is to how to install VS Code and Node.js. Do not worry about Node.js, do not worry about it as of now. Today we are just going to see how to do the installation, then probably in the later on videos I will discuss what is Node.js and what are the benefits of Node.js in our Protractor learning. So first thing first, let's begin. So the record software are only two. As of now we need only Node.js and VS Code Editor. Now just to give an introduction about Node.js, Node.js is, so I can say somewhat like it is on a client side, it's like a server which is going to act in your client machine. That is what Node.js is as of now. But as a test automation engineer, we are going to use the Node.js for our dependency management tool. If you are familiar with Selenium or Maven project, probably you know that we have something called pom.xml, where we add all our dependencies and the dependencies are get downloaded from the internet, right? So that is what also going to do the same thing in our case for our Protractor, where Node.js is going to act as a dependency management system. Of course, it has many other features, but in later on videos I will talk about it. Okay, and then of course we need the VS Code editor, which is one of the open source and lightweight editor where we can write our JavaScript and TypeScript. VS Code is basically integrated with built-in programming language JavaScript and TypeScript, but it also has other language support as well. So in this tutorial we are going to learn the JavaScript, then we are going to head over to the TypeScript, and then probably we'll learn our Protractor API, right? So let's do the installation. So project setup, we will come back to this in a moment. Now let me go to my Chrome, and here I'm going to download the Node.js first. So just go to Google and type Node.js download. That should bring you to the first link, and there are two versions available. One is LTS, which is long-term support, and another one is current. My personal recommendation is go with the LTS version, because the current version might have some new features which might not be tested yet. So obviously go with the LTS, and based on your system, so whether Windows, Mac or whatever the operating systems, you can download. So here I have Windows machine with 64-bit, so I'm going to download this MSI installer here. So let me download this. Okay, so download is completed. Now let me open this, and sorry for that. Okay, now here we are going to just click on next, and you have to accept the terms and conditions, then click on next, and it is asking for the default path. We can leave as it is. Maybe if you want you can change, but I would not recommend to do that. So next, click on next, and here it says that we are going to use the runtime environment, and it is going to also use the package manager and some documentations, and then it is going to add to the path. Now when you are trying to install Java or some other programming language, you might have to install you have to set up your path, right? But while we are going to install this Node.js, the path will be automatically set, so we need not to worry about this. So now click on next, and it will ask you whether you have to install the chocolatey, which is like more of like, if you are familiar with Python, it is like pip. So you can install all the libraries from using chocolatey, but in our case we need not to do this. So next, click on next and click on install, and of course it will ask you for your permission, so just give yes, and it might take a few seconds. After that's it, done, right? So we'll wait till this get over. We'll discuss in detail about what is Node.js and how we are going to use and what is the use of like how we are connecting Protractor with the Node.js and everything. But as a starting video, I just want you to set up, do the setup and do the project setup, then probably we'll move to the next thing, right? Now click on finish. So that's it, guys. So we have successfully installed the Node.js. Now to make sure that you have installed correctly, go to your run and type cmd, which will bring this command prompt where you can type like npm -v. So that will give you like node package manager. Now 16.13.4 is the latest one, so we are good to go. Now just exit this. Now we are done with our Node.js. Now we have to install the VS Code editor. So let me go to my browser and just type VS Code download, and it will take you to the first link. So now again, based on your operating system, you have to download. So I'm going to use the system installer of 64-bit here, and it will take few seconds to download. So let's wait until the download gets completed here. So it's based on your internet speed, it is going to download as much as faster it could. So okay, so the download has been successful. Now let's click on this. Now obviously you have to give the permission here, so yes, and then you have to accept the terms and conditions, then click on next. Click on again, it's asking for you the path where you want to set up, so let's go with the default, and again it's default, so next. And here you have to make sure that you are going to click all these options here so that it will know that VS Code has been added to our path, the environment path, and also we are getting this add with open with. The use of this is like, for example, when you go and right click here, you can see refresh and view some settings, right? So when we select this options, it means that we can open any folder using right click in the VS Code editor. So that is the useful of this. Now click on next and click on install. It is going to be very fast, maybe a few seconds. So let's wait here. Okay, so that's it, we are done. Now no need to open this, just click on finish. Okay, so here done. Now if you see right click, and here I can see that open with code, right? So that is the use of that, where we have added that in our installation process, right? Now I'm going to create a new folder here. So let me go to my PC, and here let me create a new folder called workspace. So workspace, it can be anything, just for simplicity I'm making as workspace, and right click and open with code. So here my code editor is going to open here, right? Now let me maximize this and just click on this. Okay, as soon as you see here, we are getting some welcome message, so close this. Okay, now let's open our terminal. Terminal can be open using Control J, so this will bring us the terminal here. So here if you see, this is Y and workspace, this is my default path here. Now here by default it is PowerShell. We are not going to use the PowerShell, we will use the command default command prompt. So select that and then delete this, and again open Control J. So now we can see that it is command prompt. Okay, now in the later on stages I will change this to Git because it is very comfortable for me, but as of now we will use the command prompt here, right? Now here I'm going to say npm init -y. Okay, so npm is node package manager. Init is basically we are initializing our project, and -y is like default, whatever the values they have it will change as default. Okay, so I'm going to hit enter now. Okay, so here you can see it has name like workspace and version with some description and some script and keywords author license. No need to worry about this, we'll see in later on. The only thing you have to worry about is when you are going to use this command here, npm init -y, you should see a package.json. okay, now if you see, this is a json file. Json file is nothing but JavaScript object notation, We'll talk about this in later videos. As of now, see that we have a name, workspace, and some meta informations, right? Let's not worry about this. Let's close it. Now, to install the Protractor API, we have to use the command called npm and then I means install and hyphen g is like global, and then we are going to say protractor. So protractor, yes, and click on enter. Now hyphen g stands for global, which means your all the dependencies are going to install in your system in the app data folder. Okay, so I will show you where the app data is. Now if you see here, it says that Koushik uses Koushik app data roaming here what my installation has been done. But to use that API in our project, we have to use the npm, same command, but instead of global we have to set it as a local. So remove the hyphen g and then click on enter. Now this is going to install the dependencies in our local folder, that is in our workspace. Now in a moment you can see here we got this as node modules, right? So here I have all the dependencies. If you go and check in this node modules, and if you go down and if you see here, we have a folder called protector, right? So where is that? Here. So here we have the dependencies, right? So basically hyphen g means global, where all your dependencies available in the global level. So let me show you that. So if you go to your run command and if you type app data, okay, so app data, not semicolon, so app data, then hit enter. Now if you see here roaming, and in the roaming we can see npm, and here you can see we have this node modules and we have this protector, right? So this is global thing where each and every dependencies has been set to the global level. But to use that in your project level, you have to install in the project level itself. So the command here is npm I and then protector. So that's it. So we are good to go now, as of now. Then we have to install the Jasmine. So I'm going to say npm I hyphen g and Jasmine here. And now Jasmine is a kind of BDD. Actually it is a BDD framework where it is going to act as a runner file for us, but actually Jasmine is a testing framework for JavaScript itself. Okay, now we have done the global installation. Now we have to initialize in our project. So I'm going to remove the hyphen g here and click on enter. So it's going to take few seconds and that's it, we are done with that now. So as of now we are done. So this is what your installation is all about. So to confirm that, you can go to command prompt and type protractor hyphen v, which should give you some, not this one, did I spell, okay, I have a spelling mistake here. So protractor, now if you give protractor hyphen v, it should give you something like this. To check the version, we have to use protector hyphen hyphen version, right? Yes. So once you give this command protector hyphen hyphen version, you should see some version number. So which means we are done with our installation as of now. So we are done with the protector installation as well as the Jasmine installation. So which is pretty much enough for now. Now there might be situations where when you are trying to do the installations and you're getting a prompt saying that you do not have any permission to do the installation, then in that scenario you have to just close your VS Code first. So close it and go to your start and search for VS Code, and then right click on your VS Code and then run as administrator. Okay, so if you use run as administrator, it will if you have any permissions error, then probably it will get resolved. So in that case you can add all your dependencies. So that's it guys. In the next video we'll see how to why not Selenium, why Protractor. We'll see in the next video. That's it for now. Thank you for watching. Hope you have enjoyed the video. Thank you, see you very soon.